FORKAST.
Hello, my name is Jacek Ławrecki and welcome to FORKAST. FORKAST, where we talk about the future of sustainable cities, about the future of energy, well, about our future. And with me today is Mr. Winston Yu from World Bank and actually the Institute of Water Management, as specialist in water. Is that correct?
Correct, yes.
What's so complicated about water? Because and how do we need to manage it? Because as far as I remember from school, water does not disappear. Like, it can, we can spill it, but then it will evaporate, then it will become a cloud, then it will rain, and we'll have it again. So what is so difficult about managing water?
Well, I think it's difficult precisely because of this hydrologic cycle you've just described. If you think about the different government departments responsible for managing water, we're very fragmented, right? You have one agency, for instance, that might be focused on water supply, another agency that might be focused on water for agriculture, another agency that's interested in navigation, another agency that's interested in hydropower, and never do these agencies ever have any means to talk about this resource as a single resource. And so I think that is actually the real complication with water management, is the way we organize ourselves institutionally to manage this very precious, scarce resource.
Why is this scarce? As I said, it is in a constant flow. I mean, the total amount of vapor, water, ice, whatever, is the same. So why is it scarce? Why should we save it?
Yeah, I mean, I guess for some places in the world, water is scarce. If you think about the Middle East, you think about North Africa. Here in Poland, you are actually blessed with quite a bit of water. The challenge is the dynamics of it, right? If you think about the hydrologic cycle, it is forever changing, both in space and in time. It's highly uncertain. And so for water managers, the difficulty is not so much the scarcity issue, but how you manage a resource that's not static. Right? That is the real challenge for water managers. If you think about other resources, forest resources or mineral resources, these tend to be static. And so the way we manage it is very different than the way we manage water resource, which is always changing. And as you mentioned, not only changing in space and time, but even in form, right? You've got ice, you've got snow, you've got water vapor. So it's quite a unique resource for managers to deal with.
We are now in Poland, so like in the middle. It's not a very dry country. It's not a country abundant in water. What should we do on a very simple terms to take good care of water?
Well, where do I begin? How much time do you have?
The Congress just started, so we can continue until tomorrow.
Okay. There's so many different issues to tackle. So we could talk about the flood issues, and for sure in Poland, floods are a major issue and they have impacts on the economy of Poland, impacts on the agricultural sector, and what hydropower you have, it also impacts hydropower. We could talk about water supply, particularly rural water supply, so in places where, you know, not non-city areas. We could talk about the energy issues around water. I mean, you need water for cooling, for power plants. You need water to generate hydropower. You need water for agriculture. So there's many, many different dimensions to the water challenge. So, you know, the top question is where do we begin?
Okay, but you have substantial experience here working on water issues in Poland. Can you tell us a little bit more about that? What did you do?
So I've had the privilege of working in Poland for the last 6 years, mostly on flood management issues. And if you will remember, in 1997, all throughout much of Eastern Europe, there were major floods. And on the Odra River, in 97, particularly bad floods. And so my work here has mostly been focused on strengthening the government's capacity to manage a flood of that size. And that requires a bit of both infrastructure, but also developing the capacity of the different government offices to respond to floods, future floods, but also to manage those floods.
Like to decrease the risk of a future flood?
Correct, yeah. So both, one about risk minimization, one also about responding. So how do you respond as fast as possible to restore services, but also thinking about the future. We're here, I'm sitting on this climate change panel, and there's a lot of discussions about whether or not we should be designing future flood infrastructure to a new normal that we may reach. The 1 in 100 year storm that you saw in 1997 may actually change in the future. And that's the subject of quite a bit of research and investigation.
I remember this flood of 1997, which you mentioned, and there was a discussion in Wrocław. A whole residential area was flooded, and people said that this was because of mismanagement, of local mismanagement, because this area, before the Second World War, where Wrocław was German, was designed as a flooding area. And then in the 60s, 70s, somebody built houses there. Is this the way to go, like to be in line with the nature? If the water wants to flood here, we will allow it to flood here? Or no, it's rather we should build dams, walls, whatever, ditches, canals, and then try to manage it that way. What's the best way?
In my view, the answer is a little bit of both. We cannot infrastructure our way out of future floods. Floods will happen, right? Floods are as old as the Bible itself, right? I think we need both infrastructure and institutions. So we need to also manage. The problem you described of people moving into floodplains, every country has this issue. Where I'm from in the United States, we have lots and lots of examples where people have moved into floodplains. Some communities are full aware of those risks, other communities are not aware of those risks. We don't know what the future is going to look like. And so we need a little bit of both. We need better planning and we do need infrastructure. People often talk about areas that we would purposefully flood in the case of those most extreme storms. And that's also an issue of debate right now. We need to keep in mind that infrastructure, though it does provide us with a certain level of protection, it also can increase the risk for those communities. You know, you imagine yourself living behind a levee, you put a lot of your trust into that infrastructure and assume that it's going to perform the duties that it is intended for. But we also know the challenges of maintaining that infrastructure, making sure we have enough funding to keep that infrastructure performing. So it's a very complex topic, but I do think in the end it requires a little bit of everything. We need a much more holistic view on how we manage this risk. Neither only infrastructure, neither only planning will, in my view, do it.
Okay, that's, well, I can't say it's very optimistic because it means that we will have floods as long as we live. But with careful planning, with being in line with nature, but also with skillful management of natural resources and natural forces, I think we can minimize the harm. Thank you very much for this interesting conversation. My guest was Winston Yu from International Water Management Institute and the World Bank. Thank you. Forecast.